Well, you probably pay with plastic a lot, especially this time of the year. But how about turning plastic into currency? David Katz and Sean Frankson are the founder and co-founder of something called the Plastic Bank. And it's not about credit cards.
No.
I suppose you could. But anyway, it's about taking plastic.
It's a fascinating story.
It's about taking plastic waste and turning it into currency. So, David, we'll start with you.
Sure.
What is the Plastic Bank? Where did this idea come from?
Well, the idea really came from my journey on the seashore. It's about, that's my place. That's where I like to go. That's where I, you know, my meditative space. And and I've just seen it degrade over the course of time. And I've continued to be motivated by the pictures of the bellies of birds and fish that we see around the world. There's so much plastic on the face of the earth, over 8 trillion pounds of plastic. Almost all the plastic that's ever been produced is still on the earth. Some little bit has been incinerated, but almost all the rest of it's
not a lot. Yeah.
Not a lot.
And a lot of it ends up in our waterways and harming animals and things like that.
Hundreds of millions of pounds every year.
Yeah, it's incredible. So then this idea, so pick it up from there.
Yeah, so David really came up with the idea that on the high level, if we just reveal value in plastic, we can make plastic too valuable to be thrown away, because when we see it as waste, it's treated as waste. But when we add value and reveal value, so this is where we came up with the idea of turning plastic waste into a currency and being able to have corporations use social plastic, which is an ethically sourced plastic that helped improve someone's life, but also kept plastic from coming into the ocean. Because one of the things that we learned is often ocean plastic started on the land and it was pushed into the rivers and waterways.
Right.
And that's how it ends up in the ocean. So if we look at the root cause of how do we stop it from coming into the ocean, this is where David came up with the idea that, again, if we reveal value in plastic, it's too valuable to end up in the ocean.
So how do you make it valuable, David?
It's about monetizing it. It's about, you know, pound for pound, it's worth more than steel.
Yeah.
But people don't see it that way.
Right.
And it already is valuable. I mean, there's a, you know, it's a commodity in the end. But people just don't see it because of the form that it's in.
Okay.
And quite often we see a bottle as just a vessel. We don't see it for the petroleum-based product that it is.
So when you say that, okay, so we've got a, in this, behind you, we've got a 100 bottles there, 100 plastic bottles. So how does that become currency?
Well, it's, you know, that 100 bottles will be probably, a couple of kilos worth of plastic, and a couple kilos worth of plastic to someone who's collecting that in disadvantage, maybe 50 cents to a dollar.
Right.
So that, I mean, that doesn't take much. You know, when, you know, we're looking at Peru, the Philippines. Out of the 100 million people in the population of the Philippines, 25 million people live under $1.51 a day. Now, certainly it doesn't take a lot of plastic at, let's say, 15 cents to be able to match that, meet that, and surpass that
daily. So somebody buys this plastic? That's what it's
called? Yeah, that's all plastic. We buy the plastic.
You buy the plastic.
We buy the plastic.
Okay. That's
plastic brokers. That's the plastic bank.
Okay.
Right? And then we add value to that plastic, and we provide that social story to corporations. And it really kind of closes the loop. It allows the consumer to expect or demand that corporations use a plastic that's been ethically sourced and improved the lives of people and kept it from entering the ocean.
Right.
And then corporations meet that demand.
So you've launched officially in Peru this week. Is this your first, I guess, official plastic bank?
Yeah, it's the first official plastic bank, but, you know, we continue to expand by working with other organizations that are already on the ground as well and providing a business system for other nonprofits to implement. And they get to become profitable as well, because a lot of people around the world are working with that community, what is better termed as a resource entrepreneur as opposed to a waste picker.
You've you've already signed a deal with Lush, is that right, with Lush Cosmetics?
Yeah, so Lush bought our first round that we took about 20,000 pounds of shoreline plastic from the shores of Alaska, shores of BC, and one of the goals that we really had was if we can take the worst case scenario plastic, plastic that's been in the ocean, been on the shores, hit by sunlight, and still fully recycle it into a product line that someone can use in the manufacturing. That's really the test of, we can start from the worst and have it just be the same. And our goal is, as we said, only about 10% of the world's plastic gets recycled. That when we can prove that the plastic cannot just be recycled, but be a complete replacement for virgin plastic, there's no need to make more plastic. Over 300 million tons of plastic gets made every year. And one of the pain points that we've learned is more people demand recycled plastic than there is supply of recycled plastic. So again, if we can take the worst case plastic and put it in product lines and show that it works in just the everyday way that people are blow molding and manufacturing.
Right.
This also reveals the value furthermore in plastic, in that we don't need to make new plastic. We don't need to mine more oil.
And, it's financially valuable and socially valuable.
Yes.
So great idea. Really interesting.
Thank you.
Okay, if folks want to find a little bit more about the Plastic Bank, where should they go?
Plasticbank.org.
Plasticbank.org.
That's simple.
Thank you very much for coming in.
Yeah, thank you very much for having us.
Thank you. All right, then we're going to take a quick break. We'll come back in a couple minutes. Stay with us.